Okay. Name and major.
My name's Andrew Green. I'm in the electronics program here at Penn College.
My name's Norman Sabin, Jr. I'm in the electronics and computer technology and robotics.
Awesome.
Great. What you got here?
Well, the temperature was reached on our little resistor setup we have here. We're trying to do a semiconductor manufacturing simulation, small scale. This block is simulated a pod of semiconductor wafers. Since we don't have a endpoint or a destination here, we just have it come back. Once it hits its destination, the robot picks it up, and the only live destination that we have are these two resistors that are measured by this RGB sensor with this thermocoupler, and we have it set right here with live temperature in degrees Celsius. Right now it's at 34 degrees Celsius. The robot just sent up an output to turn on this heater relay to heat up these resistors, because their power rating is only 40 watts, but they're 1-ohm resistors, so we're sending 0.5 volts through them, and they're in parallel circuits. Once it hits 50 degrees Celsius, they're in range, and the robot knows to pick it up. This can simulate like a semiconductor curing stage or like a temperature stress test, and then it goes to the second destination, which, since we don't have one of those, we just have to come back and repeat the process.
This first project in this program, we wanted to do everything. We wanted to use every component we've worked with so far this semester. So,
this pretty much simulates everything that we learned throughout the semester. We have infrared sensors here, because we're not usually compatible for inductive material. We have all the way back to Gaussian glass, analog resistors. We're using an analog module and a thermocoupler that we weren't even taught yet. We have relays at the module, which no one really likes relays, but we don't care because we're bosses. We got our power supply. We have our PLC normally open, normally closed. Our e-stop. Here's our PLC program with a function for the thermocoupler that we weren't even taught, but Andrew Green figured it out, and it's just a basic function with a, here's next semester's lab, we just stole it from Moser, and it's just a basic slope intercept function with a multiply and divide and a comparator for setting up our in-range.
You would want to spend your weekend.
And the robot just completed the full cycle. Here's Josh's 70,000 step program for his robot. And it's running like a boss. Pretty much win at everything. Right when it goes to pick up the semiconductor pod from the bear belt number 2, it has a pretty mean slip at the wrist. And we have our post-it notes here for our sweaty robot palm to stick to the semiconductor. The robot places on the heater, so it's going to heat up again. There's the live temperature, 3 Celsius, 44 degrees Celsius, 77 degrees Celsius. The carrier here, communicating with the robot through this dry input. That'll pick it up, its temperature reach. So put it where it needs to go for temperature reach.
Everything is controlled with PLC. And ladder logic. Everything is programmed with ladder logic from the basic.
And once it gets back from here, it'll tell the robot to pick it back up. And since these conveyor belts are so narrow, Josh programmed it to do a pretty good flick of the wrist right here. You didn't see that coming. Bang, bang, old block, 300.
What would you do?
I'm going to be.